This is an average action report for FlashPoint Campaigns Red Storm. Today's scenario is Jerry's Revenge. This scenario is a user-made scenario from part of a campaign. Unfortunately, the campaign doesn't work. So this scenario has been broken out and is being played in solitaire. There are so few scenarios for Flashpoint campaigns that everyone is savored, because once you play a scenario in Flashpoint campaigns, it's pretty much spoiled, because the same units start at the same place at the same time almost in every scenario. So there is no fog of war. When I play a scenario, I always try to pretend that I know nothing of the other side. And now with the new scenario, I actually don't know anything of the other side. So the fog of war is total, which makes the new scenarios a treat. Because there are so few scenarios, this scenario was played in version 2.10. Normally, version 2.10 is avoided like the plague because it's so buggy. However, this scenario was written with version 2.10, so it must be played with version 2.10. Here's a scenario background. The briefing, there's time messages that will be sent, okay? Here's our orders. This is the second scenario in the battle set, in the campaign. Now, as we scroll down, it says do not read until 6 hours or 360 minutes have elapsed. So we won't spoil the surprise for ourselves, and we'll wait until 3 hours elapsed. The scenario is 12 hours in duration. This is the mission orders. Oops, went down too far, so we won't read the until after 6 hours elapse. We'll take a look at the victory points and see that there are 12,500 victory points on the board. And the victory conditions are, we need approximately 40% for a draw, let's say 50% to win. So approximately 6,000 victory points for a marginal victory. Let's take a look at the map. This is a user-created map. We'll remove the units, and we will see that the victory points, there are 2,500, 2,500, and 5,000 already in the hands of the enemy. On the far southeast corner is my starting zone, and we have our 2,500 points. Interesting to note, all this territory in the middle is like a great big huge trench. It's all elevation 1 and with only 20% cover, almost as little as the minimal cover. So looks like this trench goes all the way through this valley floor. We have some thick forests, a high elevation, elevation 4 here, and some exit points. That's kind of odd. Especially since we have exit points on our side of the map, near our starting points. So I have to think of a plan according to what my orders are and the tactical situation and my forces available. Let's take a look at the victory points. We have 11,000, or we will have 11,000. Approximately 11,000 points, while the enemy has nearly 15,000 points, and we have to attack into the enemy's strength. That doesn't sound like a very good idea. Normally when you attack, it's a 3-to-1 ratio before the attack is launched, and we even start off with less than the enemy. Now we get a number of our forces. We start off with two Panzer one Panzer Regiment and one Panzer Jäger. This is an anti-tank regiment with some self-propelled and some towed anti-tank artillery. A second Panzer Regiment appears after, comes in piecemeal, I think, after, where is that? After 2 hours, I think it's one battalion at a time. 2 hours, all 2.5 hours, 4 hours approximately. So we don't get all of our forces at the start. However, we look at the enemy side and we know that he's got, the game tells us they have 15,000. We have no idea if they all start at the same time or if they arrive as reinforcements. However, the only prudent assumption is to believe that they are all 15,000 are already on the map. Now we could hit F6 to see what the NATO forces consist, and we could check and see what types of units the enemy has. But that's kind of spoiling the surprise. If you have a total fog of war, there's no need to peek, in my opinion, at what the enemy has. I want to be totally surprised if he comes in with, if he's supposed to be British, but I don't know if he's got chieftains or centurions or if he's got tornadoes or Lynx helicopters or any of that. I want to be surprised. We'll take a look at our order of battle. And we start on the southeast portion of the map. I have to get across here in order to capture these victory point locations, and I have 12 hours with which to do it. Here's my plan of action. I'm going to try avoiding this desert, I'd call it a desert, or I would also call this killing ground. There's just no cover. If we take a look at this is all 20% cover. It's nothing. There's not a stick of wood, not a tree anywhere in here. Even though they're different colors of brown, they are the same altitude. They're all elevation 1. So to cross this, the enemy has superior sensors. He could probably sit on the edge here and see the entire east side of this canyon. What I've done is I've set up my Panzer Regiment here. We're going to see if we can't advance through cover, through the woods up here. And I've taken a look. We'll go through here, out, and then down across, and then try to cross at either here or here at the narrowest point before making our approach in towards the city. I've got 12 hours and I'm going to take advantage of it. We're sending the scouts racing forward and we're going to take a 30-minute break to resupply and refuel, maximize the readiness of our follow-up combat elements while the reconnaissance fans out for. We want to stay in cover and don't want to risk the expensive tanks. The Panzer Jäger Regiment consists of anti-tank. They would be three companies. Three companies, each with two. I've mixed them all up. They have two towed elements and one self-propelled anti-tank section. I have a sneaking suspicion that the enemy might be coming across here. So I'm using the reconnaissance unit to come up here in order to keep an eye on this approach. At least he'll be able to give warning, shout out, if anyone comes down this flat area, this desert. I call this killing ground, and I'm keeping the Jaeger units in deep cover, in the deep forest, behind the city, so that if any enemy comes down this road or comes around, they will bump into the anti-tank section, and hopefully we can give them a big bloody nose. Outs, because when we're keeping a one hex buffer from the outer edge. If I situate the Jaeger unit on the edge of the city, he can see quite a distance, but that also means the enemy can see and engage him at a distance. By keeping it within the city, my visibility is limited, but I'm expecting if the enemy is sending marauding units, the British have a large number of scouting vehicles, such as scorpions and scimitars. The scorpions are very difficult to detect, so whenever I play against the British, they always have marauding reconnaissance vehicles. So I'm expecting anything that comes skulking around will bump into one of my anti-tank sections, and they only come, I think, two per section. So two or three per section, so we should be able to wipe them out fairly quickly. But we don't want them to see us, so if they want to get nice and close to this victory point location, that's great. Then we'll punch their lights out from close quarters. I'm staying away from this area, keeping the artillery in the rear to support the attack. So that's my strategy. We're going to see if we can work our way across and then move across and then up. We've got a full 12 hours with which to complete the objective. The units move out. The weather turns foul. 2,000 meters visibility. The enemy will be find it more difficult to detect me, but I will not be able to see them as well until nearly point blank range, 500 meters or so. My main force units drop into resupply, and the scouts continue their screening activity. My combat units are resupplied. Reconnaissance unit bumps into an enemy reconnaissance unit. We exchange fire. We lose one armored car, and the enemy loses one as well. The enemy retreats to the north. Like I said, the enemy always seems to have lots of these little reconnaissance units. They are everywhere. This designer seems to always read my mind. Or else he just designs a scenario well enough that it covers all approaches. I never expected to see him this far forward, so I'm glad I sent the reconnaissance through first and not let him see my main force units. Because if he can detect the main force units, he can call in artillery to destroy that NATO always seems to have. I have to maintain vigilance, because he's smart enough to put a reconnaissance unit up here to watch into the valley. He could have recon all throughout the map, and the little scorpion and scimitars are very difficult to detect. I have to resupply my reconnaissance unit because it used up half its ammo engaging the enemy recon. Bring the artillery onto the location where we saw him run, and we get a telltale tooltip, meaning that the tank is destroyed. I can't know how easily it was to destroy him, so I have to drop a fair number of artillery to ensure his destruction, because I do not want him lurking in my rear. I don't want him coming out and detecting my units and calling in artillery. I want to make sure that he is dead, dead, dead. The weather remains foul, and we detect another enemy recon unit. More artillery barrages go in. The problem with barrages is that every barrage I fire allows the enemy to counter-detect the artillery location and kill them with counter-battery fire. So by to wipe out a dinky little recon unit is exposing my artillery to great harm. Another reconnaissance vehicle is detected here. These are little worth maybe 20 points each. To destroy them with artillery means that the enemy can destroy my artillery with counter battery. A second reconnaissance unit is detected on the hill. The weather has cleared, 5,700 meters visibility. It is quite interesting to note that we have noticed the white dots. We have detected the enemy units, and this is shown by the white dots. But the enemy has not counter-detected my units. So this quite rare that a Soviet unit would spot the enemy before the enemy spots me, especially when I'm in command of Soviet forces. My concern is that the enemy may have spotted me, even though I don't have the white dot of counter-detection on me. My unit might still be spotted. It doesn't mean I'm not spotted. I think the white dot indicate is more for laser dot or radar detection. If the enemy has me under visual observation, I might not know it at all, like binoculars or infrared, until the first artillery barrage arrives. The improved weather is just as I feared. The enemy can spot all across this valley with his phenomenal sensors. I call for smoke to cover my motorized rifle and advanced tank elements, because I just don't know if the enemy sees us. I've got to waste smoke missions from my valuable artillery and leave them possibly destroyed by counter-battery fire. We have to destroy them quickly, so we bring all the batteries that can bear onto the tank, onto the recon unit. We hit him with three batteries and destroy him right away with the first burst. Excellent. From this location, they could easily see right across the other side. The S mobility symbol tells us that this unit will be destroyed this turn. There it goes. There's the telltale tooltip confirmation that the enemy unit was wiped out. We conduct resupply with our other elements as the combat elements creep up. And I had to stop my forward advance because I did not wish to risk counter detection by the enemy. 1 hour, almost 90 minutes in. I'm sending one unit up here to provide flank security. If the enemy was smart enough to put a unit here to watch over the area, we should do the same. Another reconnaissance unit is detected in the valley, moving south. I think this is a little ferret reconnaissance car. Boy, this guy's moving. Boy, he's got this moves. At least three positions, four positions now. From this location, we'll take this. My best reconnaissance unit is this Korshun. I will hit shift left click on here. If my Korshun was here, these are all the hexes that I could see. Notice he could counter detect us and my tank as well as my motorized rifle company. If I can see it, he can also see it. Now, we haven't got the white dot of counter detection on us, so maybe we're just lucky. But he's pretty much deployment has been frozen because I don't dare go forward. His one little unit can look all the way into the ridges and report my passage. These are very thick woods and very slow passage. If the enemy has several turns with which to strike us with artillery before we can get past them. So I've ordered all my units to go to ground and hold position. Stop where you are. Call the smoke and see if we can't get rid of this recon with artillery. Look at that recon unit run. We call for more protective smoke onto my motorized rifle company. We're just sitting here waiting. The enemy doesn't have to engage us, doesn't even have to kill us. All he has to do is keep us from traversing this valley or this killing zone across these forests. We sent the artillery after him. I think we hit him. Maybe we didn't. He's disappeared. Every time we fire the artillery, we give the enemy a datum point for which he can fire counter-battery missions. If he detects them. So, he's using the recon to draw fire and doing a really good job of it. There he goes. He showed up again going north, and we still can't get past him. We don't dare move. Look at him shuck and jive when he's coming up on this hill. We see he's going north, so he has to slow down to try to get into the forest. We've caught him in the open, and we hit him with the artillery and smash him. One recon vehicle destroyed. There's that S mobility symbol, meaning that he gets wiped out this turn. I'm quite surprised that the enemy still has not tried for counter battery. Normally, after the single shot, the AI has the range on my artillery and gets a shot in right away. If it has artillery within range. More smoke comes out. I've got to use it. I don't want to lose a single unnecessary casualty from enemy detection. But the enemy recon unit is wiped out. That's four recon units wiped. 1, 2, 3, 4. The enemy has lots of little recon scouts out there. Insurance rounds. But they also expose my artillery to counter detection and destruction. My second regiment, battalion from my second regiment, arrives as a reinforcement. While they're sitting here, I conducted resupply. They are well rested and rearmed and refueled. The weather turned soured again. 2,000 meters visibility. I am faced with a dilemma. The weather is not horrible, but it's pretty bad. He's cost me 2 hours of delay just to get this far. So I'm really at a loss. I think I'm going to have to take the risk and come in through the middle, straight through the valley, because I do not have time to come up through here and squeeze through here like toothpaste out of the tube. So I have brought the reinforcing battalion straight up the middle. If my regiment can get past here, I will try to use it to screen the reinforcing battalions. I've destroyed four. Hopefully there won't be many more. And I'll bring the reinforcing regiment straight up the middle. I drop them into resupply in order to maximize their readiness and ammo. Let's hope the bad weather stays and the weather improves just when I don't need it. I'm keeping a close eye on my units to make sure of that white dot of counter detection on them. That telltale white dot will tell me whether or not the enemy knows I'm here. I'm quite surprised I haven't seen any. It looks as though none of my units have been detected by the enemy. The good weather, 6,000 meter visibility, means that I don't dare come to the valley yet. Here is another enemy reconnaissance unit on the south. He's counter-detected in the south, but he does not see me. Wow! Has he seen us? I don't think so. There's no white dot of counter-detection. I'm aiming for this center area and these, trying to dig in on these entrenchments, these reinforced positions. In a fourth position, supposedly has lower visibility for the units and gives us protection as well, bunkers and trenches and whatnot. By coming down through the valley, I'm watching closely for these white dots of counter detection. It looks as though I've gotten really lucky. The enemy has not been able to detect me. I thought that by killing 1, 2, 4 enemy scouts, I thought that would be it. I thought that might have been reasonable, but nope, the enemy's got another one here. I'll take my best reconnaissance unit, the Corsian, again, and I'll shift click on this location. If I was here, this is what I would see. Notice that. Look at all these units. All these areas. They could be theoretically being detected. But the numbers are quite low, so I'm hoping that I got lucky and the enemy did not detect me. The numbers in the 12s, no higher than 20. So I might have gotten away with it. the reinforcing battalion also brought their artillery. So now we have 6 battery of 120mm Gewurztraketen guns. We bring them all onto the reconnaissance unit. Hopefully, we have 1 secondary explosion, meaning that is a tank killed. A second barrage, nothing. But the S mobility symbol means it will be wiped out. I was hoping to destroy it with artillery and then bring the reinforcements in without being seen. I'm gambling a little bit here. If I miss, I've got 6 chances. I think I fired 1 salvo from each battery. There we go. The telltale tooltip tells us that the reconnaissance unit is destroyed. See, my units in the valley all went to ground. Not all. The ones further away and outside the zone of detection. I checked to see if they could be detected, and I don't think they can. Just because I cannot see them does not mean the superior enemy sensors cannot. So I took a risk doing that. I'm bringing in the reinforcement tank battalion. We're aiming for these reinforced sites so that we can go into hold positions so that we can try to hide from the enemy. My skin just crawls on the back of my neck when I'm covering all this open ground, knowing that if the enemy had a couple of tanks up here, he could shoot the tank out of here. Dusk, the sun is setting. I risk a quick rush across. That's 5 reconnaissance units. That's gotta be about it. How many more can he have? That's about right. I sent the caution out north to give us any advance warning screening, and I'm using the headquarters to provide flank security. These are the smallest units I have and the most expendable. It's just a headquarters squad and an armored personnel carrier. So they're a tripwire defense. If there's enemy up here, they'll let us know if the scorpions or scimitars come skulking around back. Otherwise, I'm sending the unit straight across because of the reduced visibility. Oh, it still bothers me. It's just terrifying to run across this open field, like run across a beach and hope not to get shot. I'm sending 1 headquarters scout unit down to the south to try and clear the south to see if there's anything out here to detect. I think we're okay. We try to end our move on a reinforced position in a bunker. Another reinforcing tank battalion appears. No white dots of counter detection. Success! We pretty much crossed over to the other side of the valley without being counter detected. Amazing. I need to buy a lottery ticket. I thought long and hard about going around to the north and circling north further, but I decided to go, hey, diddle, straight up the middle, right through the forest. I've wasted 2 hours trying to get across up here, pinned by visibility against these rock faces, unable to move because of the reconnaissance. Now that the enemy is gone, I'm hoping that I can make up more lost time by bringing in my reinforcing tank battalion straight down the center. I'm doing the same as before. I'm charging forward with the recon elements and the motorized rifle because it's okay to risk the troops but not the tanks. In addition, I'm sending the reconnaissance unit through as fast as possible. By sending the reconnaissance ahead, I can keep the combat line units resupplied and rested. The recon units and the headquarters unit. Because the headquarters is the most expendable and cheapest part. Here come the reinforcements. Looks like we're okay getting across. Still no counter detection. And once they drop into the woods, we'll try to resupply them. That way, we will let the headquarters and recon elements go forward to find the enemy. Reinforcing tank battalion is fully resupplied, and I'll be bringing them forward next turn. Still no indication of the enemy main line of resistance. No counter detection either. My forces continue to surge forward. the recon units up front. Night has fallen, but it's clear, and visibility is 500 meters, but it's clear. So the enemy IR sensors are pretty good, and they should see maybe 1,000, 1,500 meters, while I'm blind. By tiptoeing through a graveyard, we get through and breathe a sigh of relief. That's just tense. It's scary! We're up on the heights. And just here's the line, here's the ridge that's just above the city. Once I cross it, the enemy should be able to counter-detect us. There he is, there he goes. We have the white dot of counter-detection, and we have seen two enemy tank platoons. To be honest, I kind of bungled this operation. I sent my units in for reconnaissance, and my headquarters got a little bit ahead of myself. I was hoping to get my other units here, have one turn to conduct resupply before sending them forward. Notice this edge of this ridge here. I'll take out the units here. This is all unit level 2 hex, edge of a ridge. Had I stayed one hex away from the edge, I could probably have escaped counter detection. He's probably on a level 1 hex, so it would be very unlikely that he could have seen us, unless he's sitting on the same level 2 here and level 2 here. He could see past us. He might be able to see it. Most likely see the first hex, but less likely to see through the forest into a second hex. So I tried to give it a buffer, but I got a little sloppy and my headquarters went in too early. So he's visible to the enemy and will probably die from artillery very soon. I have both panzer regiments coming through the woods. I've left the anti-tank section to defend my victory point location, because there's not very much. They're not very mobile, they're not very effective or very fast. So they're situated as guns, they're situated inside and inside the village and best used as ambush. I've called in the 152mm guns onto the enemy tanks. We have two fireballs, two challengers, the top shelf opponent. The white dot is just aggravating, damning. I bring the rest of my units and we're staying one hex away from the edge of the cliff so that we can conduct our resupply. We're one turn early. We drop more artillery on the enemy tanks and are rewarded with another fireball. Look at the T symbols here, mean that the unit will survive and they are not wiped out this turn. That's not good. My airstrikes they're all in the resupply at the moment when I detected the enemy. Just bad timing on my part. So I see that we have not yet been counter-detected. I'm fairly confident that if I stay one hex away from the edge, the enemy probably does not see me. Look at all these stacks I have here. A few barrages of artillery and I wouldn't have a tank battalion. I got a little sloppy. Instead of dispersing them, I let them pile up. There we go. We're dropping into resupply. We want maximum ammo, fuel, and readiness. I'm racing my reinforcing tank battalion across the floor. Normally, I don't like to race at hasty speed, but I think we're okay. Oh, here we have detected a self-propelled anti-tank unit. I think these are Spartans or Strikers. Two! He's counter-detected us. Oh, crap. That's what happens when you get sloppy. I got a whole stack of units here. Look at all those white dots. And he's moved past us, and he's lost us. Amazed. I can see him, and he cannot see us. Never happens for a change. It is really nice to be able to see the enemy without being seen in return. It almost never happens. We still have his tanks moving to the southwest, and this tank is just sitting here. So we're going to bring the RT back onto him, as well as onto these units. Looks like he's trying to move into the woods up and around to intercept my units. I'm glad we saw him at such a long distance, but he's already counter-detected this stack, so I expect them to die next turn. A headquarters, artillery, and a tank company. Oh, it's gonna hurt. It's gonna hurt. Amazingly, the enemy does not reply with artillery. We hit them with the light mortars, 80 millimeter mortars. Hopefully, they will be enough to kill these thin-skinned vehicles, and we do get secondary explosion. One self-propelled anti-tank vehicle is destroyed. A second fireball, just from light mortars. This is because they're running around in an open hex. The coverage here is only 20%, minimal open ground, and they're butchered by the mortars. And two more fireballs. We bring the heavy guns onto the tank. Even though he's in motion and exposed, he is not destroyed. We get one more explosion, but the unit is not wiped out. I'm using the 120mm guns as well as the 80mm mortar. These are medium, I think, artillery. Another fireball at two! Looks like both units are wiped out. That was close. Those guys are scary. I did have a couple of insurance rounds in case he wasn't moving as fast as anticipated, but I have nothing to worry. We remain undetected, except for this headquarters unit. Well, looks like the enemy has lost track of us, so it was probably the tank in town that detected them, and not the one in the forest. The heavy guns search for the tank platoon. One more fireball, and the tank unit is wiped out. There's that telltale tool tip. Firing from the open valley makes my guns even more valuable. There's no cover for my artillery. In order to get through the forest, I rush through at very hasty speed. The hasty means that the troops run down their readiness very quickly, but that's the only way to deal with this huge, huge forest. There's no cover in the valley when I fire my artillery, so I've tried to get into the trees. At least we have some protection. I'm very surprised. He always has effective counter-battery. I should have lost a company of artillery already, but boy, am I glad I didn't. And we've just finished resupply. Looks like the headquarters, they've lost track of us, because the white dot is gone, probably after the destruction of this tank platoon. The bulk of two Panzer regiments have arrived, and I'm sending them forward. The late arrivals will conduct resupply and act as reinforcements. The first reconnaissance vehicle comes up on the ridge, and we immediately detect tanks in the town. We are taken under fire. The reconnaissance cars try to run for their lives, but they're annihilated on the ridge. That was quick. 1 minute. Another reconnaissance with caution approach from the south, and tanks up on the ridge. We're looking to try and get over and down into the one hex. The tanks engage as we cross over the crest. Two tanks are destroyed, but I brought the motorized rifle company along because the AI tends to target first priority is headquarters, and then maybe air defense or reconnaissance or anti-tank or artillery. And then it's motorized rifle, infantry, and finally it's tanks. So bringing the motorized rifle company along. I brought along a friend. It's like their friend. Bring a friend to a gunfight. It gives them someone else to shoot at. So that's why I brought the infantry, because the AI tends to favor engaging the infantry. At least it gives them more targets. It draws the fire away from the tanks. We're still getting some, but at least it's divided with the motorized rifle company. If it was just the tanks, we would probably already have lost the tank company. The motorized rifle units are so large, they have 30 elements. It takes a lot of killing by the enemy. The Corsian gets into the valley and confronts another tank, and is immediately hit, ambushed, and shot in the face. Wiped out in a single salvo. The enemy looks like he's trying to displace in the north, and the other one to the southwest. The tanks run onto a barrier. Look at these barriers! Like a great wall of China! Look at that, a whole wall, like a Berlin wall. And I notice that there's a gap here. So either I'm not seeing it, I didn't detect it, which is unlikely, or maybe there's a minefield here. There's a line of barriers, and why would you leave a gap? So if there's a gap, I suspect mines, personally. But he's really brutalized my tanks. I've lost three of my tanks, but we're now on the barriers. We drop into a hold, and we need 30 minutes to clear. This is 90% coverage. At least I have some protection from the trees, but I'm still exposed. And the enemy is trying to run, thankfully. He's in motion, so it makes him just as vulnerable. So I've lost a reconnaissance in the north. Look at all these red grave markers. We engage the enemy tanks. Oh, great! There's an S mobility symbol here. We wipe them both out. Fantastic! See what happens when we get into cover and hold position. We are more stable, and I think we fire better with greater accuracy. The advantage returns to us. We call the artillery, but it's the tanks with the main guns which destroy their units. My reinforcements finish their resupply. The enemy engages my motorized rifle, killing an armored personnel carrier and a squad. The heavy artillery lands, but he's already been destroyed. Our three batteries and 152mm towed artillery. We have a secondary explosion. Another Challenger explodes, but they fire back and destroy one of my tanks. He evades to the southwest. We know he dies this turn because of the S mobility symbol. Artillery catches him even as he moves into the other hex. He's not followed, but we're aiming for the other unit. We detect the same tank in the gap, and he's running to the northwest. We're hoping to shoot him from short range with the anti-tank unit. This is a terrible idea. I ran in here at such close range that they are not able to dig in. Look at, they cannot ambush the enemy. They're so exposed here. There are four self-propelled anti-tank vehicles are destroyed right away. Bad idea. Within minutes. God, oh my goodness. Eight vehicles are destroyed. But we fire back and kill one Challenger. But actually this is worthwhile because we lose another one. That's 9 out of 10 vehicles are destroyed. We kill one tank for that. My motorized rifle advances onto the open field, a barrier. This is another error on my part. I knew the barrier was here, but I was stupid enough to advance onto it because this hex is, notice, is its coverage here is 20%. It's open field, and so I'm trying to breach a barrier in an open field while the enemy is firing at me means that there is no coverage as I try to dig past the barriers. An obstacle makes it target practice for the enemy. I could have dug here or here instead, but stupid me, I just march straight ahead into the nearest open field and commit suicide. What a dumbass I am. Don't do as I do. We bring in an airstrike on the tanks, and the fireball indicates that the tank is destroyed. The second strike comes in, we taking fire from this hex, but the bombers hit the tanks in the open field as they try to displace to the northwest. Let's hope we kill a few Challengers. We get one. That's two destroyed out of, I think there's three. But that one tank is quite effective. Kills another, oh, how many? Stupid. Two armored personnel carriers die from my stupidity. I'm just too eager. I rushed it. I should have taken my time, closed slowly, and used my anti-tank properly. But offensively, they are not very effective. Defensively, they're great for ambushes and can deliver quite a hurt on the enemy. It is also significant to note at this point that the anti-tank, if I wanted to overrun the and engage the enemy at close quarters, I don't think this is possible any longer in version 2.10. It was possible in version 2.08 and earlier, but in 2.08, the AI will not allow you to enter an enemy-held hex, even under assault mode, even with an anti-tank unit. So what's the point of having an anti-tank unit if you cannot order them to engage the enemy closely and destroy them? I'm pretty sure this has got to be a bug, because we could do it before. I can understand some units not being going forward, but this is anti-tank. They are dedicated tank hunters, tank killers. As a version 2.10, all they can do is ambush. When the enemy comes to them, that's fine. But for offensive operations, they are very limited. Six hours has elapsed, and I'll read my late orders. The orders state that divisional recon estimates that the 7th Armored is arriving in the area of operations at this time. You are to form defensive positions at any objectives you currently hold. This sounds suspiciously like the old Napoleonic order of form squares, prepare to repel cavalry. Since I only own one victory point location, I haven't captured any of the other ones yet. Darn shame. I'll continue my operation, but I will be wary of operations around my victory point location. I've got my anti-tank already deployed, waiting for the scorpions and scimitars to come skulking around before I pop them in the face. If there's more tanks coming, we'll see how that works. A headquarters unit is detected in the north, coming south at high speed. Oh, this tank unit is destroyed this turn. Great! He moves to the northwest and is destroyed by my motorized rifle troops. The enemy already has the range. He saw it last turn and is able to call the artillery onto my motorized rifle troops. My infantry gets hammered. We're in the woods, so we have some protection. We're in hold, as are the tanks. The tanks are hit by one barrage. That's three barrages so far, and one tank explodes. That's four. We'll count how many artillery batteries the enemy has. The motor rifle troops are caught in the open. Just slaughtered. Two armored personnel carriers destroyed. At least four enemy artillery batteries are available. This is the first real introduction of the enemy artillery. The headquarters runs up along the highway. Order my motorized rifle ahead, and we jump onto another barrier to try and clear it. We need some more openings here to get through. I've called the airstrike on the town, and it detects another tank, I think. Let the smoke clear. Yes, it's a tank unit. Whoa, but no luck, no destruction. A second airstrike comes in. We hit a second target. We didn't even see it from this motorized rifle company. Three more tanks. In the east, I'm pulling back one anti-tank unit to reinforce the victory point location to create a barrier buffer within the town. The anti-tank have 100mm armored piercing as well as AT-10 anti-tank missiles. The range is 5,000 meters. Hopefully, if the enemy is here, he will not be able to detect the anti-tank unit. Hopefully. Once they get in here, we will be able to surprise them and hit them at point-blank range. the developers have said that if a unit is surprised, then the a higher probability that the thinner up or side the top armor or side armor can be hit instead of the tougher front armor. We engage the tanks, but we're trying to conduct resupply, so we're more exposed. No, the white dot of counter detection, possibly from this location or this location. So he calls his artillery onto my tanks. Sloppy, sloppy play on my part. I'm stacking them up. I gave the enemy a chance for a double score bonus. Somebody sees my reconnaissance unit and calls the artillery onto it. We lose one unit. We lose two armored cars. The enemy blast into my tanks and destroyed another two tanks. There's only three left now. We're trying to get up the resupply. We move forward and pick up another enemy tank. A tank platoon engages across the road. Well, this clearing. This tank will also be wiped out this turn. But three of my tanks are already destroyed. I bring my tanks over the top. The entire tank battalion is stacked up here. This, I can say it again, sloppy, sloppy play on my part. We engage the enemy and destroy one. But we've just stacked up three tank companies on here, an entire battalion on 1X. And we've shown what happens when artillery hits a tank company. And I've just given them 30 tanks to destroy. Here comes the artillery, and I'm telling them, kill me! Kill me! The artillery lands, but we survive without loss. Follow-up artillery misses my tanks as they move forward. My reconnaissance unit gets hit again by artillery. We're really shooting it out at close range. The enemy fires and destroys a tank, and we get nothing in return. He's taken out three of my tanks, but we return fire and as he tries to evade to the northwest, and we destroy the last challenge. 3-4-3, we'll take that any day. A stack of tanks appears on the road in the east. Looks like two tank platoons coming down the road. This is not good, it's in my rear area. They're overrun the anti-tank section and destroy one of my guns. One of the towing vehicles, looks like. Looks like reconnaissance is heading up the road. And infantry is coming down. We overrun the enemy tank unit with our T-72s. We're in the village and we destroy all three challengers. Another carrier is destroyed, but we managed to destroy one challenger. At least we got one. That's well worth it. We fire at close range and destroy another challenger in the village. We go into hold. It looks like it's a T symbol, so he survives this turn. I forgot to mention earlier that the anti-tank section is only worth 6 victory points, so the entire unit is only worth 60 points overall. They killed one challenger worth 120 points, so we have a 200% return on investment in that situation. It's still very heartbreaking to watch them get slaughtered, but at least we know that all I need to do is get lucky with one shot, and it pays for the entire unit. Same with my anti-tank guns. These are worth 14 points, so a total of 100 points or so in the unit. We kill a challenger is worth 122. So, even if by killing a challenger, if he wipes out the entire anti-tank unit, we're still pretty much a draw. The tanks in the town open fire and destroys the surviving enemy challengers at point blank range. Now, more tanks, two, maybe even three tank platoons come down the road. I've zoomed out fairly far at 53% so that we can keep track of the action in the west and east. I'm sorry if this makes the symbols very hard to see, but any other zoom level, we wouldn't even see what was happening. The tanks overrun and we destroy another challenger. So we've doubled our investment already. I've dropped a mine in front here because The anti-tank section has held up and delayed the enemy, so it forced him around, and it should make him drop into the minefield. Mines are more effective if the enemy runs onto them and if you drop them right on top of the enemy. If you drop them right on top, they will attack the enemy and then be instantly cleared. But if the enemy runs onto them, the probability of destroying something is much higher. The challengers run onto them, and we managed to destroy one. Now he's pinned here, and next turn we can bring the artillery onto this hex. But look at all these tanks. He's got these one tank company here, probably two. With the challengers, destroy the ferret armored reconnaissance vehicle. Another tank platoon appears. So it looks like an entire tank battalion has shown up appear in my rear. We try to move an anti-tank section up to reinforce, but the enemy overruns it. My tanks advance, and we capture the 5,000 victory point location. So we're in the town in force. No sign of the enemy. We've destroyed at least a company of tanks. In the east, my anti-tank section is overrun. We're trying to move up in here to reinforce the city, to bolster the defenses, but it was intercepted by an enemy tank platoon and overrun. Looks like my tanks here are still holding by the skin of their teeth. Oh, hey, this is interesting to note. See that this symbol here is an S mobility symbol, but that there is no S mobility. I guess it's for something like maybe anti-tank weapons, stationary perhaps? The T is for tracked vehicles. It indicates the unit is under tracked mobility. At least the carriers are tracked. The towed vehicles are tracked. Towing vehicles. But notice when this one says S, this means that it does not mean that the unit will be wiped out in this turn. So that's very odd. I guess they can't put an L here since it's, because it's not a leg unit. It's just noting that in this instance, the S mobility does not mean the unit will be destroyed. We're engaged closely with the enemy, and I think my anti-tank wipes him out. Wow! Two challengers! Without loss. We've dropped into hold because we could not move past the challengers as they overran. Now that he's trapped in the minefield, we're bringing the artillery onto him. This triangle indicates he's trying to move to the south, and we destroy one of the challengers. We should be more exposed when in motion, but we're not killing them fast enough. We've brought 2-3 barrages onto him already. In the town, he's got a headquarters unit evading to the northwest as we advance. A second salvo catches the tanks in the minefield, but no secondary explosions are seen. There we go. We got one. Another challenger is destroyed. Very slow going. Very tough tanks. The tanks now move around my anti-tank barrier. My third and final barrages arrive. I thought we should have obliterated the entire tank company, but there's still a survivor up here. The headquarters tries to retreat, but engages my tank and destroys one of them. Damn it, because of lousy weather. We can't see him. He can see us as he slaughters us. A headquarters section comes in, and we engage with our headquarters and anti-tank. The weather's cleared up. At least it stopped raining. The tanks bypass. My anti-tank fires and destroys the reconnaissance or command unit. I think it was a command unit. The tanks disappear from view as they clear the minefield. Another infantry platoon is detected coming in the west, coming south. The Striker anti-tank vehicles come up on the town and they bypass. My anti-tank section has displaced. run from the original, running for their lives. The enemy brings heavy artillery onto my headquarters now that reconnaissance has detected it. The anti-tank headquarters takes a loss. The headquarters squad is destroyed, as well as one anti-tank gun. The enemy tanks enter the town. My motorized rifle advances through the town, and we engage the headquarters as it tries to flee to the northeast, but the enemy supporting mechanized infantry platoon fires and destroys a motorized rifle squad. We return fire and destroy a carrier and a squad within it. We overrun the headquarters element. Now we're at close quarters. The tanks, two tank companies come up and we blast the enemy headquarters unit. My other tank company has taken losses and evades to the southwest. The enemy tanks overrun my anti-tank section. Nicely done. The enemy headquarters squad destroys one of my armored personnel carriers. Another mechanized infantry unit comes down the road, destroying one of my machine guns. The weather is clear, so we can see. The tanks open fire and destroy 3 armored personnel carriers and 2 squads. That was great shooting. My anti-tank survivor goes into the village to provide intelligence. And an anti-tank Milan unit comes in from the west, engages my motorized rifle troops, destroying an armored personnel carrier. The strikers bypass and destroy one more anti-tank gun. 2 more tank platoons have entered the town. I have seriously underestimated the threat in the east. I thought it was just some small units, maybe even a tank or so, or maybe a company, but I think he's brought an entire battalion or more along the east side, along with Striker anti-tank vehicles. If it had just been a few marauding anti-tank or scouts, the anti-tank guns would have been just fine, but up against an entire battalion, I don't think so. But we've got all our strength in the west. The infantry tries to bypass, but I think this S mobility symbol here means he gets wiped up along with the headquarters. Another headquarters section rolling down the road engages the motorized rifle troops, destroying an armored personnel carrier. We fire back and get one armored personnel carrier too. Another vehicle, a scout, seems to be heading north along the highway. The enemy overrunning my anti-tank section destroys a carrier. We get a tank in return. Fair trade. Do that again. The tanks fire and destroy the last squad from the headquarters section. Anti-tank section has bypassed and are moving towards the south. The weather is clear. Trying to bring the airstrikes in now. We tried to drop mortar fire in front of this headquarters unit, hoping that he would run onto it, but he has not. We're bringing the heavy artillery onto the tanks, hoping to kill them as he tries to move into the city. Medium artillery hits the strikers. One fireball. The second strikers are caught in the open. This was in the city. This one is an open field. The medium guns do much better, even against thin-skinned targets like this. A third explosion means that the striker vehicles are wiped out. More wasted artillery, hoping to catch that headquarters unit. Damn! I was really expecting him to come forward. The red triangle showed he was coming, but I guess he's waiting here for 30 minutes. The enemy overrunning my victory point location destroys another gun, anti-tank gun, and the carrier. The enemy overruns my anti-tank section. We do bring artillery onto the surviving infantry squad. So I did get something. Get lucky on some, but not lucky on the headquarters unit. Self-propelled artillery unit is already destroyed. These artillery survivals are just wasted. As are these. The self-propelled anti-tank strikers fire and destroy two of my anti-tank guns. We duke it out with the tanks. Another tank platoon appears. Enters from the north. My anti-tank section retreats to the northwest. Now we're trying to lead the infantry by dropping in front of it. But we also have some enough and are able to drop right on his head. One salvo wipes them out. Counter battery! All three anti-tank companies are engaged closely. Counter battery hits my medium guns. Two are destroyed. Wow. The enemy counter battery has really taken a heavy toll on us. The 120mm self-propelled artillery again is hit and we lose another one. It's just lethal. This is not counter battery, but my motorized rifle is being hit with artillery directed from the headquarters unit. Lose another armored personnel carrier and two more infantry squads. That's 6 batteries might be firing on me. He's trying to hit my anti-tank section. I count 6 salvos in the same minute. So I think he has at least 6 batteries. Luckily, my tanks are not detected, so they do not take heavy damage. He hits the... When a unit is detected, see that white dot? It makes the artillery fire more effective when they have a spotter for it. The anti-tank, fire and kill a challenger! Superb! The resistance is terrific. And we get another one! They're dying, but they're dying hard. Counter battery hits the mortars. Now here's a stupid thing I am. I fired them last turn, and I kept moving units right atop of them, so they're stacked up on 2 and a hex. This gave the enemy a double score bonus easily to hit them with counter battery. So when it hits, they got both of the unit, the firing unit and the unit in transit. I was stupid. I was lazy, I saw this happening, and I wasn't bright enough to change course. I'm an idiot. Now a single artillery barrage gets a double score bonus, wipes out twice as many as it normally would have. I deserve that. I'm an idiot. More counter battery. Oh, I'm going to hit the 120mm guns. I'm going to pause it here and talk about this. Now, if you see this artillery unit, it's trying... It should be noted that the unit is trying to escape to the southeast. See that little black triangle there? As is this one. The little black triangle. He's trying to evade at very hasty speed. He's trying to scoot or displace. This one's trying to go to the southwest. He's on M. He's using deliberate. This one's on 2. So he's using a hasty movement order. Now, unfortunately, he'll never make it because there's a bug introduced in version 2.9. Artillery is unable to displace into another hex, even if it's a friendly hex or a friendly unit. So long as it's occupied by another unit, the artillery unit will not displace. What happens is, we'll go into hasty move or deliberate move, but he'll want to go to move. He'll be very exposed posture. He'll try to go into this hex and bam, 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 bash his head against this unit and cannot get in. When the counter battery fire actually arrives, he's more exposed and it'll blow the hell out of him and it makes him takes more casualties than if he had done nothing. This is a 2.9 bug. It does not exist in 2.8 or earlier. In 2.8 or earlier, the unit would simply have moved into the other hex. So it's doubly bad. It cannot move. 2, it actually forces the unit to be more exposed so that it can be more vulnerable and take higher casualties. will continue. Artillery continues to hit my motorized rifle company. Wow, just pulverizing them. Thank goodness it's such a good unit. Two more squads and a grenade launching squad. The anti-tank squad company is, oh sorry, anti-tank section is also under fire. One carrier is destroyed. Oh, we fire back, we get another Challenger, but we lose more anti-tank guns. Still a good trade. 14 for 120 points. Damn fine. We'll pause again. The enemy has somehow sent a reconnaissance unit overrunning my headquarters picket line. Enemy artillery hits my motorized rifle again, destroying a machine gun squadron. My anti-tank has moved forward. As noted earlier, this is as far as I can go, because not we cannot overrun the enemy position, because version 2.10 will not allow it. What all we'll do is we'll go into haste, we'll go into movement phase, even assault movement phase, and we'll just keep trying and trying, and then we will just stop here and get slaughtered. So all we do by trying to move is expose ourselves to more vulnerability. The enemy brings artillery onto the anti-tank as well as the overrunning enemy unit. He's hitting his own unit. That's fine. We take no losses, and he inflicts no losses either. More artillery hits an anti-tank section in town. We survive. He fires again. Just we can't see him, and he's just using us as target practice, slaughtering my motorized rifle company. Here comes a major headquarters. Large headquarters unit is bypassing. We can see the plus unit here, meaning that it's a mixed composite unit. It's got 5 Ferrets, 2 Challengers, 5 Sultan command vehicles, and 4 headquarters squads. That's the estimate. But fog of war, that may or may not be true. All we know that it's big. Could be a regimental headquarters or brigade headquarters. My headquarters is standing in their way and counter detected it. During the overrun attack, we destroy another one of his... Oh, we wipe out his Challenger unit. Excellent. The headquarters clash, but his headquarters is bigger and it has tanks. Destroys 2 of my armored personnel carriers. My anti-tank has fired, but he brings artillery onto my headquarters and my anti-tank section, destroying 1 more anti-tank gun. The AI has been pretty good about doing a double tap. He also brings it on top of my headquarters and his recon unit. We both survive. I bring the heavy artillery onto his tanks as they try to move in the city. Nope, no results. Even though he's in motion, these are my heavy 152mm guns, we are unable to kill one of these tough Challengers. Look at all those artillery strikes we have on him. We're firing the 120mm just to harass him as well. Unlikely to kill anything, but we can hope. Now we're bringing the artillery onto the headquarters unit as it tries to bypass, destroying 1 command vehicle, Sultan, and a headquarters squad. More artillery hits the headquarters unit. 2 more command vehicles and 1 headquarters squad destroy. The headquarters unit finally decides to come down the road. We smash it, we destroy one of his reconnaissance vehicles, command vehicles. My little sliver of anti-tank survivor is really doing well. Fires again. There's a motorized rifle company underneath it, and we, a platoon, and we destroy the warrior and the squad with it. More heavy artillery lands on the enemy tanks. Nothing. We hit the headquarters again. He's in heavy terrain, so it's taking him a long time to travel through this hex, exactly as it should. We're smashing the hell out of him. Another headquarters squad along with the ferret command vehicle. There's a motorized rifle platoon noted. It's a Milan anti-tank unit is noted going northward towards the bridge. We bring on the mutual, my own, no, I'm calling in my own artillery fire on my own unit, trying to smash his two his scorpions, or maybe there's only one left. Maybe we got one already. Another ferret armored car is destroyed. We fully resupply in the town. We have that 30-minute respite. We are back up. The enemy destroys another one of my anti-tank guns. Two. A carrier and the gun. But the counter battery catches my units as they are still firing. Really hammering the 120mm Gvozdka. Two self-propelled units are destroyed. Two self-propelled vehicles are destroyed. Another one gets artillery unit gets the double tap, resulting in the carrier and one self-propelled gun. We bring more artillery onto my headquarters unit, and we destroy the enemy Scorpion. You can stop firing now, guys! Stop! We hit the anti-tank section as it tries to move northward, destroying a armor personnel carrier and a Milan team. We overrun it. We're racing for the bridge, trying to get a foothold here. The enemy has moved into the forest north of us with, looks like a machine gun. Headquarters squad. So it has a machine gun unit, and we destroyed a few of the carriers as well. We destroy another mechanized infantry squad. It's trying to move to the northwest, possibly to protect this bridge. We hit the tanks again with heavy artillery. They don't even seem to be scratched. More artillery hits the headquarters as it tries to bypass. I think it's only the tanks are left. Still hard to kill. Stop firing! Enough! Enough! Don't kill me! Don't kill me! That's my own artillery! But we finally scratched that flea off our back. The headquarters looks like it has made its way. My anti-tank just displaced. We destroy another armored personnel carrier and infantry squad. As we are in close overrun, the enemy anti-tank unit destroys one of my armored personnel carriers and a headquarters squad. We lose another 100mm gun. My little anti-tank unit fires again, gets another armored personnel carrier and Milan team. Excellent. But the enemy counter battery is just superb today. He hits another one of my self-propelled artillery pieces, destroying the carrier or ammo carrier, I guess. The headquarters section has bypassed, and we destroy it with artillery, one warrior and one rifle squad. The single anti-tank launcher fires again, kills another armored personnel carrier and Milan team. Fabulous. But we lose an anti-tank gun in the east. We lose another armored personnel carrier and motorized rifle squad in close combat with the enemy anti-tank team. But we destroy only a ferret armored car. Look, his strikers have come. Another striker comes down the road, engaging my anti-tank section, destroying one anti-tank gun. They fire back. Oh, that was a good deal. The strikers are pretty valuable. I think 30, 35 points, whereas my gun's only worth 14. But the counter battery is really ripping apart my artillery. He's swirling around this motorized rifle company. We've stopped moving, and his anti-tank section continues on to the bridge. Why, this motorized rifle, artillery, self-propelled artillery is down to 50%. They started with 8, now it's only 3. Just getting butchered. Oh yeah, that's because we can't run away, I forgot. Bug! The tank leaves the village and comes forth to destroy one of my anti-tank guns. Looks like another motorized rifle platoon is coming down the road. The enemy headquarters finally leaves the hilltop and bypasses totally. The enemy anti-tank section disappears northward, but we catch another anti-tank section in the open, destroying an armored personnel carrier. The headquarters section tries to evade to the northeast and is finally wiped out. We kill another Milan anti-guided missile team. Counter batter continues to beat on my artillery. Double tap. We engage. Oh, looks like this Milan unit will, and this infantry unit will be wiped out. An enemy anti-tank unit moves down the road and is engaged by my tanks. Unfortunately, we are in resupply mode, so it makes us more exposed and vulnerable. We destroy 3 armored personnel carriers and drive the Milan anti-tank guided missile teams northward. We bring the heavy artillery onto the enemy challengers. No luck. They disdainfully ignore it. Look at all that artillery. We're firing the 120mm as well, trying to keep the enemy from leaving. By hitting him with artillery, we still reduce his... He can kill it, but if we don't kill it, we can still reduce his readiness and morale. If we reduce his readiness and morale sufficiently, he keeps staying in... He keeps dropping into perpetual automatic resupply. We destroy another armored personnel carrier. So we trap him in the hex. Right now, I've been trying to bring air strikes on it, but the weather just stinks so badly, the planes won't fly. So if we can keep him trapped in the hexes with perpetual resupply, then we can bring, hopefully, the weather will clear so that we can call in the floggers. We keep hitting his motorized rifle unit. Mechanized infantry, I guess they should be called. With all of our small mortars. These are 80mm mortars, but they should have an effect. He's only got a small infantry unit. We finally wipe out the enemy infantry. He was an open ground hex, so he had no protection. My anti-tank section moves back into the village. We hit the enemy tanks again. Still dropping the heavy artillery. Still getting nothing. More artillery. The 120s continue to drop. Look at all those batteries. Six batteries of 120mm Gewehrstücke cannot even put a dent in a tank. The light mortars continue to waste their additional salvos on an empty field. My anti-tank is active, destroys the enemy self-propelled anti-tank. Take that! Two strikers in flames. The tanks engage on the open field and wipe out the enemy Milan unit. Fantastic. Another salvo of heavy guns. My final. Now we're bringing the 120mm Gewehrstücke. I think all we're doing is advertising our locations and letting the enemy smash us with counter battery. But what else is there to do? You have to try. We seem to have fought off all the enemy attackers from all directions. Have a brief respite to bring up reinforcements and more artillery to resupply and rearm. But the enemy off-map artillery doesn't give up. Hits us again with counter battery, destroying two more Gvozdka self-propelled guns. Another battery is taken under fire. Taking losses. This hurts. We're probably down to third for all of our artillery so far. Oh, another mixed motorized rifle mechanized infantry unit comes down through the bridge and immediately tries to retreat to the northwest. Our motorized rifle troops open fire and destroy another warrior before the Milan anti-tank guided missile team evades to the northwest. We get out just in time. Enemy artillery hits my tank company, but we were not detected, so the artillery fire is not as effective. It hits my motorized rifle troops as well. They survive without loss. We're bringing the light 120mm again. Hey, it's cleared up, so I call for airstrikes. We hit strike all around. He has tanks with no luck. All we're doing is getting ourselves killed by the enemy counter battery. A tank opens fire on one of the anti-tank companies and destroys another 100mm anti-tank gun. Even though they're stacked up, we're not able to inflict any losses on the enemy. The 152mm are like pea shooters. And the 120mm are just a joke. But notice the enemy no longer has red triangles. He's no longer trying to move because we've hit him so often and so often that he's dropped into automatic resupply. He's now hopefully more exposed. We'll try to get him. An enemy headquarters section comes southward. It's got two units. I don't know what the other one is underneath it. Artillery hits my anti-tank section, destroying another carrier, tow vehicle. Second salvo destroys the gun itself. The headquarters section fires and destroys one of my armored personnel carriers. The Milan unit evades to the northeast. We drop artillery as well. We hit them. To no effect. Still no effect. Well, other than running down his morale and readiness. No physical. Well, those are physical too. No lethal effect? Maybe. But he's doing just fine. His tank opens fire and destroys another carrier, tow vehicle. My artillery comes too late. We move in another motorized rifle company trying to head for the victory point location. We're trying to get eyeballs on the target in order to call in more artillery or more effective artillery. My artillery tries to displace to the south and is caught in motion. Another gun is destroyed. Another unit tries to evade, rams his head against the wall, unable to leave, and two more are destroyed. Uh-oh, a second salvo hits the same unit. More explosions. This is the ammo carrier. The enemy gets a double stack. I've got two units trying to move forward, but they're on top of each other, so he gets double points. Kills one. Infantry, armored personnel carrier, I think. Oh, here comes another mechanized infantry platoon. Wow. He really wants to fight for this victory point location. Counter battery kit, just the same unit that's just been decimated the turn, the 2 minutes before, 3 minutes before. He gets that double score bonus again. I've got two motorized rifle companies trapped on the same hex, trying to go forward. We cannot enter the other hex because we're on deliberate attack, not assault. If we were on assault, we could enter the hex, but deliberate does not allow us to enter an enemy-held hex. We do fire and kill one of the Milan anti-tank guided missile teams. But they're sitting there, and they're getting hit by artillery, and the enemy gets a double score bonus. Just when I thought I could get my air strikes in, the weather turns sour and scrubs the mission. Good. You can't even have good enough weather for 10 minutes in this game. Ah! The enemy hits my anti-tank unit again, killing another tow vehicle. The enemy motorized rifle, mechanized infantry trying to come southward, destroys... He drops artillery on us, but we survive. My unit is going in assault mode, trying to overrun the enemy unit. We fire on... Is this a Milan team? Yes! It's an anti-tank team. He moves forward and detects another anti-tank team here. Just the subunit survivor, as well as a motorized rifle, a mechanized infantry platoon to the northeast. We destroy the rest of the headquarters unit. Wipe it out. Artillery for the turn continues to hit the enemy. My first barrage goes in. Nothing. What a waste of time. I've redirected some of the artillery onto the more vulnerable infantry. We hit them. Oh, we get several secondary explosions. It's another Milan anti-tank guided missile group. We're dropping the light mortars all over them. Not much there. Even though it's a little bit of coverage, we dropped just, I think, six or seven salvos without killing anything. The enemy destroys one more tow vehicle. A headquarters section comes down the road, and we engage with a nine tanks, slightly damaged company. He's severely punished. Three armored personnel carriers and an infantry squad are destroyed. Second salvo, probably just like all the other ones. We might annoy him, but we sure can't kill him. The 80mm mortars hit the enemy Milan section again. Wow, look at all that. Second salvo. Oh, I still don't think we've gotten a kill yet. 12 barrages on there. The enemy headquarters section overruns. Wow, that's some brave headquarters section. Looks like a scout unit or armored personnel carrier has been detected in this long trench. He hasn't detected. We haven't detected him. There's no white dot of detection here. He's detected us, and I think he's engaged. My anti-tank section is driven out of the city, fleeing for their lives. We're bringing the 128mm onto his Milan section, along with the 80mm mortars. We see one Milan section has evaded to the northwest and one to the northeast. No, that's a... that is a Milan section, yeah. Looks like the 80mm mortars are just too light to have much effect. The headquarters squad hangs on doggedly. Counter battery hits the mortars. One transport vehicle is destroyed. And a self-propelled mortar unit. Mortar squad. No, mortar vehicle. Self-propelled mortar vehicle. The Gavolstica unit, it was fresh. Now it's 50% down in 1 minute. Wow, that's incredibly lethal counter battery. Another 80mm mortar section is hit. One vehicle destroyed. Another squad comes down the trench. Looks like this is a mortar unit and a mechanized infantry, perhaps, or headquarters section. Another Milan anti-tank guided missile team heads to the northwest. We engage with the tanks and destroy one Milan anti-tank guided missile team. Fine. Self-propelled anti-tank launcher moves northward. Engages the enemy Milan unit and destroys one. Counter battery catches the mortars again. One fireball, the utility is destroyed, the transport vehicle. Another mortar unit is hit. We survived this time, this salvo without losses two times. Now he concentrates his fire on my motorized rifle troops, destroying an armored personnel carrier. I move another motorized rifle company survivor, Sliver, I guess it's one-third, up to help block the enemy reinforcements coming down the road, or at least punish them. My surviving Caution reconnaissance unit destroys an enemy mortar unit, mortar vehicle. Another headquarters section comes down the road. Oh, we finally destroy the enemy headquarters squad. Look at all those tanks. It took us 40-some-odd tanks to do that. The mortar runs right into my reconnaissance unit, right towards them. More artillery hits my motorized rifle troops as we try to destroy this Milan anti-tank guided missile unit. I'm trying to pull out this unit is really low on ammo, trying to get some separation from the Milan unit so that we can get a full reload. The enemy drops artillery onto my other self-propelled anti-tank section, covering. We were put him here in ambush, but it didn't work out very well because he wouldn't fire! Damn it. The reconnaissance unit fires on the enemy mortar and destroys a mortar vehicle. We pull the tanks out. Because they're at 30% level, 30% ammo, time to reload. We don't want to be stuck close to the enemy and unable to conduct a full reload. We're bringing in fresh squads to engage. The anti-tank section fires and destroys the headquarters. That was the mortars. 80mm mortars destroyed the headquarters squad. Now we're dropping it on the Milan teams. He's trying to flee to the northwest. See the little block? Triangle, that shows his direction of movement. He's in, and the black means it's very hasty move. This red could mean either deliberate or assault mode. It's unknown. The heavy artillery, offboard artillery, hits the tanks. The enemy's kind enough to stack him up, and we still cannot kill him. It's a gift horse. We simply refuse to accept the enemy's gifts. We drop the 120mm. Nope. If the 152mm could not do the job, how can I expect the 120s to do it? There's not much choice. If I don't fire them, they're out of the game anyway, so you may as well use them up. We bring in the anti-tank section. We're going across the bridge, I guess. Enemy artillery fire catches my tanks as we try to retreat in order to conduct resupply. We're stacked up, double score bonus, but we survive it. I think it was mainly because the enemy did not detect us. If he doesn't see us, it's less effective. We fire on the enemy at another Milan team heading to the northwest. Boy, I don't know, I should count how many this self-propelled anti-tank unit has destroyed. I think he's made up for the other 9 lost brothers of his. The mortars hit the Milan team, retreating to the northwest 2 or 3 times, still there. Here comes that heavy artillery again. What a joke, eh? I don't have any better targets for it. Mind you, the offboard artillery has taken approximately 20-30% losses from counter battery fire. My decimated Gvozdika, there's only 2 left, fire on the enemy tanks. Nothing. More mortars. Oh, sorry, the Gvozdika 120mm hit the Milan anti-tank team. No result. Oh, looks like another enemy motorized rifle, mechanized infantry platoon coming southwest on the river. We drop more 80mm on the Milan anti-tank missile team. They're on foot, so hopefully they're more exposed. We hit another Milan team. Instead of going to the northwest, now he turns around trying to go to the southeast. More mortar fire hits the surviving Milan team. Nope. Still there. Final barrage of this turn for heavy guns. 2. No secondary explosions. I guess all the experienced gunners are dead. The 120mm, we're trying to aim for the Milan anti-tank guided missile team. Aiming ahead, but he changed from the northwest to the southeast in the blink of an eye. We destroy, oh wow, 2 Milan and a ferret. I think we wiped it out totally. That was a headquarters unit for the Milan teams, I think. Enemy counter battery fire catches my mortars. One self-propelled mortar unit is destroyed. Self-propelled mortar vehicle. I pulled out the anti-tank section, resupplied it, and ready to send her back in. Weather's gone still sour. Counter battery hits the mortars again. We've run forth and we've tripped. It's at a minefield, I think. A tank section appears and starts destroying 2 armored personnel carriers and a squad. He's just brutalizing my mortar rifle troops. Another armored personnel carrier explodes. He overruns with a Milan group. Close combat, we destroy the Milan anti-tank team. Right, both wiped out. Fabulous. Because we're dug in and they were trying to move. Counter battery hits the mortars again. Blowing up another mortar vehicle. We fire on a Milan unit in the north, on the northern road, and wipe it out with 7 tanks. This Milan anti-tank meat team survives. We're hitting it with artillery, mortar fire. No luck. Wow, we're wasting it on an empty road. The enemy closes. Oh, no, we're firing on the mortars. They've turned around and we're firing. The reconnaissance unit is firing on a mortar section. Heavy artillery. Nope, pardon me. I think that's only... There's 120mm guns. Barely chipped the paint on these tanks. Mortar bypasses, another mortar section comes down, and he's right next to my anti-tank section. Fantastic. The S mobility symbol means we wipe it out this turn. Medium artillery hits the tanks again. They're still hitting the Challengers. Nothing. Look at all those targets. And nothing, no weight of shell sufficient to destroy them. Sometimes I wish I had a nuke. The Milan section is caught by 120mm Gvozdika, and we destroy one more anti-tank guided missile team. An enemy, I think it's a tank? Is it the tank or the Milan launcher that fired and destroyed another armored personnel carrier? My self-propelled anti-tank really go to town on the enemy self-propelled mortars. Three are slaughtered. Oh, my motorized rifle troops fire and destroy a Challenger. The anti-tank section fires again, wiping out the enemy mortar unit. We hit the Milan survivors again. No luck. Pounding them with 80mm. 120mm versus Challengers. Just look how tough these tanks are. But my units are mostly at 50% strength, so they're not firing a lot of shells either. The Milan team is hit again. We fire and kill another tank! Whoa! Challengers! Counter battery catches my mortars. Fireball. Oh, it's the carrier. Visibility, it's dawn, but the visibility is still lousy at 2,000. We can't call the airstrikes when so long as it's raining. We evade, and the enemy counter battery fire misses my artillery, my mortars. Small blessings. I bring another anti-tank unit into the south, trying to draw fire away and occupy the enemy tanks. Counter battery. I think we've already been wiped out. Maybe that... Oh, no, we evaded to the northwest. There was a hole here, see? He finally found the hole, and he evaded, but he took losses all the while he was sitting here, getting hit. Enemy counter battery fire hits my mortars. We move tanks onto the victory point location and grab the points. Now we're in close combat. We're close range with the enemy tanks. Here comes that artillery. My artillery. Just pathetic, isn't it? This is supposedly the heavy guns. And the 120mm Gvozdika. Looks like this mortar unit will be wiped out this turn. These mortar units are cheap. I sent artillery, 120mm artillery after the mortars, but they fall behind it. Displaced too quickly. Counter battery hits my mortars, 80 millimeter, as they try to resupply. They're more exposed, and we get another fireball rises into the sky. Double tap. Oh, gosh. He survives the second salvo. Another mortar section is hit while trying to fire, losing a mortar vehicle. A second mortar attack and a second vehicle is destroyed. We're moving tanks up to try to engage these tanks. The reconnaissance section opens fire on the mortar unit and wipes it out totally. Second salvo. For all those who claimed supposedly that the Soviet artillery was something to be feared, I don't know. Not in this game. Enemy tanks advance and destroy an armored one of my motorized rifle squads, an armored personnel carrier. They retreat. They're forced out, but the tanks hold them in place. So long as we hold them close, the enemy will not be able to conduct resupply properly. And he's driven off my tanks. Luckily, I can say that there's still a T here, so they still have sufficient vehicles for all their troops. We can move them next turn. Counter battery hits the Gvozdka, trapped in the middle. Two more secondary explosions. Wow. Another Gvozdka unit hit. He survives the first salvo, but the second one kills another self-propelled vehicle, artillery vehicle. Off-map artillery might have 152 millimeters. Shooting at the tanks. Look at all that. I wonder, well, maybe we should go back later and count all the salvos which resulted in zero kills. I don't think artillery has killed a single tank in the village yet. Could be wrong, but I don't think so. Looks like we picked up the Milan anti-tank guided missile team survivors, trying to head northward. Counter battery hits my battered Oh! Gets another kill! Holy cow! There's just not much left of this unit. One single mortar vehicle. Counter battery hits the Gvozdka. Look at all that. The ammunition carrier is destroyed. This vehicle tries to flee at high speed to the south. Cottmore is more exposed and pays the price. Another reconnaissance vehicle or ammunition carrier destroyed. A reinforcing motorized rifle company comes up and helps out in destroying the Milan anti-tank guided missile team. The tanks fire, shoot it out with other tank, the enemy tanks. We lose another one. Artillery hits the motorized rifle survivors as we escape to the south in order to conduct resupply. We lose another squad. Enemy brings artillery onto my tanks. We haven't had a chance to dig in yet, but at least we're stopped. We've stopped moving. We're on hold, so it's still, I think, better than a unit that's in motion, less vulnerable. Ah, the enemy tank section will be destroyed. We bring in two fresh tank companies to engage while we pull out the depleted one to rearm and resupply. The artillery falling on the enemy tanks is almost a joke now. We still have the lousy weather. Can't call the bombers. As we pull out an infantry section to resupply, it dropped into resupply automatically after engaging the Milan anti-tank guided missile team and killing it on the road. Enemy artillery fire double. two salvos land, but we survive without loss. Because we're not, I think mainly because we're not detected by the enemy. The enemy brings his own artillery onto my anti-tank unit, and his is much better, destroying another anti-tank gun. Another 120mm barrage to waste. The Challenger is destroyed, but he lasts long enough to call artillery onto my tanks. He's unable to provide artillery correction, so the artillery fire is less effective. More artillery hits my anti-tanks, destroying another anti-tank gun. Most of ours are fully resupplied. Final battery. This is the 152mm off-map artillery. And now a second one. Counter battery responds quickly. I'm trying to move another anti-tank unit through the hex and into this one to tie up the enemy resources. But two salvos, just bad luck, bad timing. Two salvos of enemy artillery from the enemy artillery destroys one more vehicle. I've brought another anti-tank up from this village. Hopefully we can shoot the enemy in the back, but the visibility is so poor, he just can't see very well. The enemy fires and destroys another anti-tank. Was it a vehicle? He's bringing the artillery. He sees the value of them. My anti-tank section is tough. They dig in hard. The enemy fires, and another one of my anti-tank guns is destroyed. Although I lament on the ineffectiveness of my artillery versus the enemy Challenger tanks, it should be noted that my anti-tank guns have been holding up quite well. Note the two anti-tank guns trapped against the edge of this map. They've been here since the beginning of the attack, yet they are still in their hold mode. I don't think they've dropped into resupply yet, because the enemy hasn't dropped them with sufficient firepower. So they've survived. The anti-tank guns in the south and the west have pulled out to resupply and start again, but these guys don't have the option. But they stay, they survive, and they soak up all the enemy ammunition, keeping the enemy tanks in low levels of supply and perpetual resupply. In the west, I've decided I'm going to try and charge for the enemy final enemy victory point location in the north. They have one here, and right now the victory point level is approximately, I barely have decisive. So I'm sending my motorized rifle and tank troops up to see if we can't try to ensure a decisive victory. If we can capture this last victory point location, we don't care what happens to this one in the south. Or in the east, pardon me. Look at all that artillery. We're dug in deep, and the enemy's trying to dig us out of the city. So, goes both ways. We can't kill his tanks, and he can't kill our infantry. We did concentrate on this unit in the open, because this is an open city, open hex, open field, so there's less protection here, and the Challenger is destroyed. More artillery on my anti-tank unit. Weather's gotten bad. Oh, it's clear! Let's see if it's going to stay clear enough, so long enough for me to actually call in an airstrike. So we've got 4 minutes of clear weather so far. Still slugging it out with the tanks and the anti-tank, while my armored personnel carriers and tanks worm their way northward in the west. Still that artillery dropping. Still no effect. Still got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. At least 7 units. They all started out as tank platoons. So probably 3 tanks per platoon in 3 platoons per company makes it about, so that's probably an entire battalion that just came down in the east. Not bad for a few anti-tank guns to hold off a far superior enemy. Just goes to show how vital, how difficult it is to remove infantry in a built-up city hex. Especially when the tanks are unable to retreat, get a full load of ammo, and come back in. The AI simply is unable to do this. My mortars and tanks resupply in the west. Oh, we did drive off one tank. He seems to be running to the northwest. At least one unit has dropped so far in morale and or readiness that he is retreating, trying to get away. Notice all the red symbols here? These are the directions of movement. But if we keep hitting them with artillery, we drop them back into resupply. There go my tanks. We pick up an enemy tank unit on the ridge, trying to defend the victory point location. My tank company takes losses. We lose one, but I have 3 tank companies here to his 1 tank platoon. He fires again, we lose another tank. Fire is returned, and the enemy Challenger explodes. 2 of them. Counter battery hits the Vostka again. We get no respite. Another self-propelled gun destroyed. The airstrike comes in. The tank is destroyed. After all that effort, one airstrike manages to kill a tank. Second airstrike. A single plane could do more than all that artillery could. My tanks go into hold position. They're more stable now, and they open fire and destroy the Challenger tank. More reinforcements follow behind. Counter battery hits my mortar, my Gvozdika again. We lose one self-propelled artillery unit, gun, and a second one. The unit's wiped out. The enemy brings his artillery onto my tanks, but we're in hold position. Hopefully, we're not counter-detected, so he won't be able to see it. I'm hoping that we'll take fewer losses. We advance to the north, and another tank company is detected. 4 against 10, or maybe I think it's only 3. I believe the Challenger tank companies come in groups of 3. So that's fog of war saying there are 4 vehicles there. The enemy tank in the north gets wiped out, but not before he destroys one of my T-72s. We've gotten into hold, but he still manages to destroy three of them. In exchange for one challenge, he fires again. Another fireball. We fire back. Get one of his. He fires again. Gets one of ours. That's 5-2 so far. He's got one more. 6 losses. We captured the victory point location. The artillery hammers on his challengers in the city, unable to kill them. He's trying to move to the south, but we're in hold. And in hold position, we should be more stable, fire better, and more accurately. The enemy calls artillery onto my tanks. It's a duel to the death. I think he's got one left. 1-4. Tanks fire! The enemy unit is destroyed. More reinforcements come in. I'm really beefing up the defenses around both of these victory point locations. Looks like the enemy has given up trying to recapture this one. More artillery hits the challengers. What I'm trying to do is, if I can destroy these three challenger units, then I theoretically I could recapture the victory point location just by having units able to exert influence at the range of one. I don't need to kill these three back here. The victory point calculation is measured at the end of the game, 1 hex around. So every unit, one either on the location or 1 hex around, are counted to see if who owns the victory point hex if it's in debate. If I can get it, if I can contest control of it or capture it by destroying his tanks, then I will be far ahead. But tanks are very powerful, and anti-tank guns are not much influence and not worth very much. So if he has even a single tank on here, he will probably be able to retain control and the victory points for the site. Counter battery catches my Gvozdika again. And he calls his artillery onto the anti-tank. Where at least they're serving a useful purpose by drawing the enemy artillery away from other units. But he does manage to hit my anti-tank section in the city. We do the same, I think. We're trying to drop him, almost trying to drop him back into resupply. The red movement arrows on these units have disappeared, I think because we drew them back down into resupply. Another tank unit appears in the north, coming southward, but we're all dug in, defending. Looks like a headquarters unit heading to the northeast. The counter battery smashes another artillery unit. This one gets wiped out too. This has been one heck of a destructive scenario. I have never lost, I don't think I've ever lost, this many artillery units before. The mandatory fire support control. A single self-propelled artillery vehicle remains. Another anti-tank carrier is destroyed. The airstrikes come in. We got clear weather. So we have this turn and one more turn, it looks like, in order to deliver the bombs. Oh, we get one! all-out work. See all that artillery, and they, and the bombers come in and kill a challenger. 120 points. I bring in more. I rearm the anti-tank section and bring them back in. The enemy calls artillery onto my lead tank. Ah, I stuck my neck out too far. He was detected by this headquarters unit, and now the enemy calls in artillery. We can't even see it, but he can see us, and the artillery kills us plenty good. Artillery hits my anti-tank again. Another anti-tank gun destroyed. The southern anti-tank gun is engaged with artillery. We take no losses, though. My anti-tank section finally retreats from all the deadly enemy fire. Artillery falls again on the enemy tanks. Unfortunately, this turn, my bombers used up all their ammunition last turn and are now conducting resupply. Unfortunately, there's only about 15 minutes left in game time, so a 30-minute supply cycle is unlikely going to... Well, we're not going to get the bombers back before the game duration expires. Enemy artillery hits my anti-tanks. We survive it without loss. We fire our own artillery at the enemy tanks. They still are trying to move southward, some of them. My plan to destroy these three units is unfulfilled. Alas, I could have brought a couple of tank units all the way back to challenge and probably destroy them quite easily. Could have. I just figured I didn't need to, because the victory points already, I have the 5,000 plus another 2,500. This was all gravy. So I've got the 10,000 victory points here already. By giving up this one, the effort wasn't worthwhile. Didn't need them. Here's the final turn of the game. 1 minute. Looks like no changes in victory points. NATO keeps one, and I keep the others. See, here's it's the range of influence is one at the end, and the enemy has three NATO units with five subunits. These are big tanks compared to my little anti-tank units. They're about a third. We'll take a look and see that we have a 69% decisive success. See, I don't need the extra 2,500. They were tying up the enemy and destroying a few tanks for free points. Take a quick look at the kills. Quite well distributed. Not just any one unit doing all the destroying. Now, this is going to look a little bit odd. I couldn't understand why the enemy had 3,500 points had left the board. When a unit leaves the board through a victory point location, this is a Soviet victory point location, and the blue ones are NATO. If a unit lands on the hex, it will be removed from the game, and the points for that unit, if it's a 100-point tank, that will be given here. So I'm just curious if the enemy had an additional 3,500 points, could he have held on instead of having them run off the board? That would have been interesting to see. I don't know where he left or what direction, because he could have left over here. I do not understand the location of some of these exit points, because in the past I have accidentally had units walk across here, and I didn't even know they were just trying to move along the edge, and they hit an exit location and disappeared. So I think that might have happened in this instance, but I don't exactly know where. There's exit points here, exit points here. Regardless, This was an interesting little scenario after getting me totally embroiled in the attack on, where is that? On these cities here, I can't even read the names. The enemy, the designer, had an enemy unit appear somewhere in the east, driving towards my home base. That was a good surprise. I was very startled. I did not think it was as powerful as it was. That must have been an entire battalion rammed down my throat, and I easily could have overcome the anti-tank guns. So this concludes Jerry's Revenge for FlashPoint Campaigns Red Storm.